Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of the New England Patriots franchise. I'm your host, Cosmic Trash, and let's get right into it. Last season, we had the worst season in Patriots history, at least since the I think like 1990 when they went 1-15. This team went 2-15. We clinched the number one overall pick, pretty easily, honestly. Not a great game, pretty bad. Not a great season. Last week, we just finished the season off because there was no point. We could tell. Puka has X Factor now. So Puka Nacua now has his X Factor, which is crazy. Deep threat, but we're getting his slot up. He's a slot receiver. Absolute franchise player in Puka Nacua. So we have an X Factor receiver who was taken in the fifth round right now. Absurdity. Interesting. I would do ankle breaker, but I don't know. Do first one free, I guess. We're gonna have runoff elite, short and elite. So Puka's a franchise receiver. Mac Jones will not be our quarterback. We are sticking and picking at number one. We're picking Caleb Williams. I've officially decided it's too good of a player to not pass up. The Cowboys go 20-0. And have the greatest season in NFL history. So it was a real bad season for us. Not only do we lose that 18-1 season, really, the Cowboys go 20-0. What can go wrong didn't go wrong this season. Tough. Players ready to negotiate. You think I'm fucking picking his fifth year option up? He's trash. Hunter Henry, superstar dev. I would give him a 1 year contract for 10 mil. So he'll re-sign for another year. That's really it. There's a bunch of trades that are gonna be made this season in the off season. Literally in week one of free agency. So it's gonna be an interesting year. Mac Jones is on the block. Matthew Judon is on the block. Yeah, there's a bunch of players on the block. The only guys that really aren't on the block is like Christian Gonzalez and Denzel Ward's on the block as well, even with his contract. All right, Denzel Ward. People love Denzel Ward, right? Wow, okay. Cap room. No one has cap room. The Lions. You have the number four overall pick. We'll trade you Denzel Ward for that. Wow, that's really easy. Okay. A fifth round pick. A fourth round pick. All right, a third this year. And then a sixth this year. Denzel Ward, a third and a sixth, netting us number four overall. That's the Brock Bowers pick. Yeah, that's the Brock Bowers pick. So we got to figure out what we're going to be doing. There's going to be three first round picks that we want to keep. Matthew Judon is another guy that we're keeping or that we're trading. The Bears, they have 11 and 12. No one else has cap room. The Cardinals have cap room. Three. You need a quarterback, don't you? What else would you like? If I were to give you Jabril Peppers, what if I moved Judon to right end? Would you take him then? That's a really big thing. Because Judon's really an edge rusher. He's not really an outside linebacker. Matthew Judon, I love him in real life. He is not worth it on this team. He really is. We're going to put him at right end. Superstar dev. He's an 85 there still. So we are in talks to trade him now. Where the fuck did he go? Oh, he just goes down. He just does not want to be on the team. You're gone anyway. It's okay. Trust me. You're getting traded. Cardinals, you want him? Third overall pick. That's fair. D tackle. Left end. I'm okay with giving you Keon White for the third overall pick. What about the 43rd pick in the draft and Matthew Judon? Yup. That gets your interest, huh? 2 seconds. We get you a second next year. What about the 34th pick in the draft instead? That piques your interest, huh? Halfback, Ramondre Stevenson? And a third next year. Or a third this year. No. Okay, they need the 34th or else they're not going to do it. Yep. And a fifth this year. Halfback. Okay, QB. I'm not going to do that trade. Tyquan Thornton. Demario Douglas. You want Demario Douglas? Crazy. Left guard. What left guards do we have? Cole Strange. Antonio Mafia. Or Mafi. I don't want to give up Cole Strange. Keon White and Ramondre. How about a second in 2026? No, I can't even do that. 2025 second. Damn. 43rd pick this year. 34th. All right, that'll do it. Sixth. Significantly is crazy. A sixth and then a seventh next year. For the number three overall pick. We now have 1, 3, and 4. We're going to trade up to 2. Who has 2? The Giants do, I believe. Giants have the number 2 overall pick, if I'm not mistaken. Yep. 3 and Mac Jones. I can't use any players in this. How about a third? You're bugging. 3 and a 5. You're once again bugging. I don't want to have to give up the 43rd, but I'll do it. They'll do it. All right. 1 and a 2 to move up one spot is crazy, but we now have our stuff. All right. We'll figure it out at the draft, the rest of them. Okay. We now have cap room. Antoine Winfield is a big one that I would love. I would love to pick up another corner. Levi Wallace. Yeah. Sione Takitaki. 1 year deal. I would love Antoine Winfield Jr. But I don't see the reason to get him. Antoine Winfield Jr. signs. Wow. That's big. Kyle Fuller, he's also available. We don't really have corners now, so we gotta pick him up. Jaron Curse. Literally, I'm trading Kyle Duggar. There's no reason to keep him on the team. I really do want to trade Kyle Duggar. There's no reason to have him. I'll see what I can get for him. We're really purging the team. Unless Jabril Peppers' contract is bigger. It probably is, honestly. Because I think Kyle Duggar's still in his rookie deal. Let me see here. No, Duggar's deal is longer. But get offers for Jabril. Teron Johnson in thirds is amazing. Grover Stewart is crazy good. J.C. Horn is also amazing. All right. Counter offer. I want the 2024 stuff. I don't want... Yeah, I want a 2024 third. Yeah. Give me a pick this year in 2024. So we get J.C. Horn. We just signed Antoine Winfield. So that makes Kyle Duggar replaceable. So Kyle Duggar, he's good. But is he good enough to keep around? I don't know. Trent McDuffie. Kyle Duggar for Sauce. Can I do Kyle Duggar for Sauce? Would that work? Could it work? It won't, but could it? Sauce Gardner has his X Factor already. I would do Sauce and the the first pick in the second round. Is it worth it to do this? No, it's not worth it to get Sauce. I mean, it is worth it, but it's not at the same time. Jair would be worth it. You guys have to give us Keyshawn Nixon too. That's not worth it either. Marlon Humphrey. Huh. Tariq Woolen. What's his, like, man, though? His man isn't good enough. Asante Samuel Jr. No. Honestly, Jets, I'll take Sauce if... Let's see what we can do. For the number 4 overall pick, would you do that? It's definitely doable. Two-thirds. How many seconds do we have? This is crazy. I don't know if I want to do that, dude. It's too much. I don't want to have to give up the number 4 overall pick in the deal, too. How about this? 2026 first round pick. You're bugging. Sauce isn't impossible to trade for. It's just that I don't want to give up this guy. Who was the best player on the team? We have J.C. Henry. Hunter Henry. What do I get? What do I get for Hunter Henry? Khalil Mack, Sam Hubbard, Jonathan Greenard, Alec Pierce, Ricky Strong. Wow, that's actually a lot that you're offering. And I'm going to draft Brock Bowers, so there's no reason to keep him. Yeah, I'll trade Hunter Henry. Whatever I get more of for Gesicki or Henry, I'll trade. I'm seeing Samaje Perine. Can I trade Hunter Henry for someone like awful? Or someone good at on the O line? We don't have a running back too. Any running backs available? JT, he just got an offer. He just got his contract in real life. Quentin Nelson? Would you do that? It would, yeah. Gesicki too. And DeMario Douglas. Not even close. Quentin Nelson now. Give me an O lineman, bro. That's all I want. Matthew Bergeron. Elgton Jenkins. That's actually not a bad trade at all for us. I feel like they'll do that. I do feel like they'll do it. A third. A second next year. How about that? A second next year. And a third this year. It's possible. How about you get another tight end and Mike Gesicki in the deal? You get two good tight ends and a third this year. And we get a really good guard. Okay, this is not gonna work. I don't wanna do that. I mean, of course I wanna do it, but like not worth it. Oh, the Chiefs player. Who's the Chiefs center that's like insane? Creed Humphrey. Puka's a beast, so I don't know what. Can we trade you a second round pick this year? Or a third round pick this year for Creed Humphrey? Not even close. Second round. Kelsey, he's gone after this year, so there's no point. The Jets do have a good tackle though, right? Mekhi Becton, right? Yeah, where is he? Oh, he's not on the team. Elijah Vera Tucker. Taylor Moton is too much money. Abraham Lucas. Charles Cross. Where's Icky? I don't know where Icky is. Yeah, Mekhi Becton is on the Texans right now. I'll do Brian O'Neal. And we'll give you. They have Hawk, don't they? They don't need Hunter Henry. No need for Hunter Henry on your team. Okay. I would love an O lineman. Paris Johnson's really good too. Giants, they have a crazy O lineman, right? Andrew Thomas. And Evan Neal. You give us a th I'll give you a third round pick for Evan Neal. Or like a fourth or a fifth. All right, fair enough. Never mind. Penei Sewell. You need a tight end, don't you? You need a tight end. We're giving you a really good tight end in Hunter Henry. You get a third round pick. And Tyquan Thornton. Mixed nothing up. Third round pick. We can give you an O lineman too if you want. We have Trent Brown, Cole Strange, center. We'll give you Lyle Collins too. We'll give you Lyle Collins back. And we give you a third round pick. We'll swap tackles. You still get a good tackle in the deal. Nope, not gonna work. All right, whatever. We have O-linemen enough. We're gonna pick up a running back in free agency though, because losing Mondre sucks, but you know. Let's get Cordarrelle. Let's get Rashad Penny. I love Rashad Penny. He's a great, he's good. He's a great player. 2 million, Rashad Penny, and then we'll also pick up Cordarrelle Patterson because he's really good in real life. I am going to trade 4, though, down just to try and build up mid-round picks and stuff. Let me get Damian Harris back. I'm okay with that. AJ Dillon already went. Okay. Damn, no one wants to sign. Cordarrelle signs. Rashad Penny is still looking. Damian Harris signs. Love to see it. Our studs. See college pro day results. We have our franchise QB already with Caleb Williams, and we have another franchise receiver that we're taking. Thing is, I can trade down to about 8, and still Brock Bowers will be there, I think. And if he gets taken, there's a bunch of players that I can either get, or I can just trade down again. Like, not a big deal. All right. So, free agency is done. I'll look at the mock draft quickly. Mock draft, that's mock draft 1. Here's mock draft 4. Bowers is projected to go to Green Bay. Is there a possibility that I trade up to 8? Or like 6 or something? So I can have a bunch of picks and then I can trade down from 4. Tight end. Hunter Henry. Packers, where are you? It would be too much. You'd have to give up someone. You give up Luke Musgrave and Tucker Kraft in this deal. Or do you have a bad contract? Nope. You don't have any bad contracts. Justin Hill is a bad contract, actually. And Devontae Watt. I almost just offered it, and that would have sucked for us. For the number 8 overall pick. Wow, you almost might do that. Third round pick, too. This third round pick. Y'all are bugging, but cool. We're going to move up to 8. Or I could just do this. Or I could just give you Kyle Duggar and not have to give up all these picks because you need a strong safety. No, I need to do that still. Or I could just give you Kyle Duggar. That's funny. Tristan Hill and then Devontae Wyatt. Tight end, Mike Gesicki. That way it's only 1 mil. I don't want to take Van Ness from you because that's too much. Dude, you got to give me something that's a bad contract. I don't want to take Eric Stokes from you because that's not a bad deal. You don't have any bad contracts, really? This is annoying. All right, I'll just attempt Eric Stokes. No, they're not going to do that. And then we give you a third this year. Y'all are bugging, but cool. No, a second next. Fuck you. A second next year. I don't want to give up that pick. Third this year. Third this year. Alright, we take away this third, we put this second in. Come on. Alright, 2 seconds. Kyle Duggar gives us the 8th pick. We're going to be able to trade down. We're going to be able to trade down now. So let's just advance free agency recap. We're going to be able to trade down now and get a bunch of picks. We're going to trade from 4, though. Scouting private workouts. Brock Bowers, Dallas Turner, sure, and then Kool-Aid McKinstry is who we want. That is a really good class that we're looking at, and we have 1, 2, 4, and 8. So we have 4 picks in the top 10. So New England, number 1 overall pick. The New England Patriots select Caleb Williams out of USC, the franchise player in New England. Caleb Williams, the most athletic player. They're saying he's a combo of Lamar and Patrick Mahomes. That's terrifying. Marvin Harrison Jr. is taken out of Ohio State. He's compared to Randy Moss. The next Randy Moss is what he's been compared to. J.J. McCarthy. Did the Jets need a tight end? I don't know. Okay, let me look at what this mock draft is right now. Can I look at the mock draft? Is that possible? Let me just see what I get. Trade offers here. At 4. Vikings offer seems to be the best. Because we get a first from them next year. Fourth this year, 2025. Let me look at the Vikings and see if I can get a little bit more out of them. 3 first-round picks and a second this year. That would be insane. Vikings, how you doing? So 4, you can get 4. Minnesota, we need picks this year and next year. So first, a second, next year, first, second, 3. That's what I want for the 4th. That's not horrible. All right, you get a 5th this year, too. Okay. And a second in 2026. How about a 3rd in 2026? Or a 4 and a 5 in 2026, so we have off. So we actually have picks. Let me look. I want to shop. I'm shopping 1. So, Rashawn Slater. Damn. Derek Brown. Damian Pierce. Okay. I just want to look and trade down again. What does 8 get me? Chris Godwin. Let's stick and pick here and take Brock Bowers and then trade 8. Because I think 8 is the thing we should trade. We'll pick up Brock Bowers here. Makes the passing attack ridiculous. Brock Bowers has 90 speed. He's a fucking animal. The number one... that's our third pick in the first round. We're trading number 8. He's the number one tight end in the class. We pick him up. Dallas Turner goes to the Jets. Latham to the Steelers. Cooper DeJean to the Saints. We're trading 8 now. That Steelers deal is pretty good. Packers deal is the best one right now. Packers deal. I want the Packers deal because it's... wait, where's the Packers deal? Packers, where'd you go? So it's a second this year, a first next year, 2024. Okay. Yep. Bunch of picks this season in the mid rounds. So we just got our pick back. And then we're going to trade away this, second. This is what I want to do. It's our pick this year. I want to trade it with the team. Let me know. I'll put it on in an offer. No offers. Okay. So this is what I want. I want a second this year, and then a second next year, and a third next year. That is nice. That's a nice pick up. Because we keep acquiring picks. And that was the 31st pick in the draft. Damn, that actually kind of sucks. Xavier Worthy still there? Because that was who I wanted. He is. Xavier Worthy. He will not be playing receiver. Hidden Dev, 94 speed, 93 jumping. He's not playing receiver, though. He's playing running back. Xavier Worthy can move around. He'll be utilized in that the role that we utilized. Holy shit. Philip Dorsett in last season, but we're going to put Xavier Worthy there. Because we have... Cordell Patterson, he can play receiver. I might cut him, honestly. I just realized. No reason to have him. All right, Chris Abrams Drain, he can play corner. He's good. 92 speed out of Missouri. That's Chris Abrams Drain. We'll play there. So, fourth round pick now. Do we trade away this one? I think we do. Third next year. This is the pick. Vikings, you deal us a third. We have a fourth round pick, or we have a fifth round pick, so I'm fine with it. Plus, we have taken the most good players. We probably have the best draft. And just the best, we didn't have the best offseason, but the best draft we have. Riley Leonard out of Duke. Is he fast? You can always take that white receiver at the end of the draft. DeCorian Patterson. Wow. That just looked like a good player. I have to take him if he's just looking good. So we pick him up. 29th overall pick. What else do we do here? Do we pick up a kicker? Who's the best kicker in this class? Harrison Mevis. Sure. Ninety-two kick power. Love to see it. Harrison Mevis is picked up. So we now have minus 28 mil in cap. We're in cap hell. But we have the best draft in the class. The best draft out of any team, in my opinion. So we got the number one and the number two players in the class, and we had the number fourth player in the class. Travion Henderson's a freak, though. I should have low-key thought about picking him up. What's his start? What's his development? Is it going to be X-Factor? Because I'm going to be pissed if it is. Star. Okay, good. But Caleb Williams is a franchise quarterback that you want to build your team around. He's wearing 13. He'll be sick. Marvin Harrison. I don't want him to wear 18, honestly. I kind of want him to wear 81. And cut ties with DeMario Douglas. I want him to wear 81 because he's kind of like Randy Moss. Brock Bowers, 19 is cool and all, but I don't know. Maybe he'll play. He'll wear a tight end number. Drake May falls all the way down to the Rams. What was the other QB taken? J.J. McCarthy out of Michigan. They pick up. The Giants pick him up. Is he good? Does he have normal dev? Please tell me. No, he doesn't. J.J. McCarthy is really good. Dallas Turner, best defensive player in the class, arguably, besides maybe like Kool-Aid McKinstry, who falls all the way to 15 to the Chargers. Keon Coleman goes to the Bills. That's insane. Malik Nobers goes to the Bills. Who did we take that's a receiver besides Harrison? Xavier Worthy. Xavier Worthy is not going to play receiver for us, though. I think he's good enough to play running back. We are going to have to develop him there. But Xavier Worthy, I think, is going to play running back for the New England Patriots. He's good enough. He would be an 80 overall running back. And he's going to wear number 3 there. No, number 9 is crazy. Xavier Worthy will be wearing... What's his college number? I don't know what Xavier Worthy's college number is. Xavier Worthy. Images. He's number 1 or number 8. Okay. We'll figure it out. Xavier Worthy. I liked him in the second round. That was a good pickup. Brock Bowers is going to be an animal. Harrison Mevis. He's wearing number 92. That's hilarious. I don't think so. We'll look at the roster right now. Adjust roster. Honestly, I don't need Cordell Patterson on the team. I don't know why I even picked him. Picked him up. There was no reason to have him. We're going to just cut ties with him. He doesn't need to be there because he's just going to be taking space from Xavier Worthy, and I don't want that. Juju, I hate him. I hate that he's on the team. DeMario Douglas, we're cutting to save room. We don't need him. He's gone. Marvin Harrison Jr. is the best receiver on the team. I think 81 is going to be cool on him. Let's look at 81 on Marvin Harrison Jr. Oh, that's clean. Marvin Harrison Jr. will be wearing number 81 for the New England Patriots. Puka next to him is fucking disgusting. Xavier Worthy would be cool and all. It's just that I think he's better suited as our back. And tight ends. It's really a Brock Bowers versus Gesicki situation. Hunter Henry, we can trade. I'm just going to cut him, honestly. I don't need Hunter Henry, honestly. I love Hunter Henry as much as the next guy, but it's a Brock Bowers world. He's just so good that I can't have him take away snaps. End situation not looking good right now, I'm going to be honest. It's pretty rough. We don't have a defensive line. The defense is the worst defense in the league, arguably. And, yeah. Steven Jones Jr., you're cut. What are you even doing on the team anyway? J.C. Horn. Wearing 8 is kind of sick. I like that. Who wears 1 is the real question. Jaron Curse. He doesn't need to wear 1. You're fine wearing 2. Or like, yeah, not 2. We're just like, we're 16. Jaron Curse will wear 16. I don't need Bryce Behringer. He's ass. Harrison Myers, you can be our punter. And he'll wear like number 2. Harrison Mevis, he's gonna play punter for us. It's gonna be a crazy good game for him. He'll be a crazy good player for us. And then Xavier Worthy will be moving to running back and wearing number 1. He's a good receiver and all, but we have receivers. And I think Xavier is going to be best suited at running back. Number 1, Xavier Worthy out of Texas. 94 speed. The break tackle is not great, but he can make people miss. I didn't trade Mac Jones yet. He's on the block. Because I forgot to trade him. I didn't even trade him. And I forgot that I could have used him as a trade chip. So who needs a quarterback? Because we have a quarterback for you. Who needs a quarterback? That's the real question. QBs, Mac Jones, get offers. Wow, there's some offers here. Oh, there's some offers here. Isaiah Simmons is cool. I would love an end for Mac Jones. Like, do the Lions need it? Oh, who did I just see that was in green? Bucks. Want to give us one of your ends? Do you have an end that I would like? Kalijah Kansi's cool. Vita Vea is really cool. Nah, we're not trading with them. We don't need to give you another quarterback. Lions don't have that much. Okay. Aiden Hutchinson for Mac Jones. Not even close. It was worth a shot. Rams. Aaron Donald? Hey, man. Nah, I'm kidding. Aaron Donald won't work. They literally are a bad team, so I'm not even... They don't have any ends. Who has ends? Cam Jordan is the only one that I would think of, but I don't even want him. Steelers. TJ Watt? Not even close. Titans. Jeffrey Simmons. Harold Landry is cool. Zeez Al-Shaair. Nah, there's no one. Vikings. Daniil Hunter. Bears. TJ Edwards. They have Khalil Mack back. That's kind of awesome. I don't see anyone that... Unless you want to give me a first-round pick this season for Mac Jones. They actually might do that because they're dumb. Fourth. Mac Jones and a third in a few years. Wow, you're really going to trade him? Is Justin Fields that bad for you? Wow, you really will do this. You're first this year in a draft that has Shadeer Sanders and Travis Hunter. We'll give you a second in this season. This is a fair trade if you do this. Ridiculous. We get a first-round pick from a bad team in Mac Jones and... For Mac Jones, and we have to pick up a quarterback now and some ends. QB, let's get Jacoby Brissett back playing in New England. And then we'll pick Malik Cunningham back up. And we need a running back again. Let's pick Zeke back up. He'll be our running back. Unless AJ Dillon's available. Is AJ Dillon available? No, he's not. Zach Moss, who has been really good in real life this season. Like, he's been legit. But I would love to trade for a really solid end this season. So, one of those picks could be gone. Because we have three first-round picks this year and they're really important, too. Or, like, a strong safety, like a Buda Baker. Marcus Epps, Derwin James, Justin Reed, James Williams. Who the fuck is James Williams? Cameron Curl, Donovan Wilson. Talahalafanga? Would you do a second-round pick for Talahalafanga? Nope, because you don't have any cap room. I would love C.J. Gardner-Johnson. Would you do a second-round pick for C.J. Gardner-Johnson? No. Brian Branch. Second-round pick for Brian Branch? Branch? Nope. Forgot you guys have Kyle Duggar now. Alright, we need ends though. What are we doing? We need ends. Like, for real. Draymond Jones. Will Anderson? What about a first in 2027 for Will Anderson? Is there anyone that you would take on our team? Trent Brown? Would you want Trent Brown for Will Anderson? Because I'll do that. Not even close. He's that valuable, huh? It's fair. Trey Hendrickson for a second round pick. Feel like that's kind of fair. It would put us over the cap room, though. Von Miller, obviously. Miles Garrett. Nope. Leonard Taylor, Logan Hall. Matt Judon. Chico Bennett. Mike Donna. Dorrance Armstrong. Chase Young. Micah would have been crazy, but... Hey, man, if the Cowboys want to trade Micah, I'll give him two firsts. Or, like, a first here. First 11 and then a first next year. No, not next year. A first in 2027 for Micah Parsons. But they don't have cap room. My God. For Nick Bosa? No. You don't have cap room. What about in first in 2027 for Aiden Hutchinson? What about a second this year for Aiden Hutchinson? No. A first in 2027 is fair for Aiden Hutchinson if we offer them a fourth this year too. Big trade. We get Aiden Hutchinson. Love that. That's a big pickup to put on the edge rush as an edge rusher. Let's give him 50. Yeah, Aiden Hutchinson wearing 50 is going to be fucking fire. And then Josh Uche on the other side. That's actually a really good DN combo, because that's those are two guys that are fucking studs. Left end, Josh Uche. And now we need linebackers, or we have safeties. So is Antoine Winfield good enough? No. Adrian Phillip, no. We need outside linebackers now. So is there any outside linebackers that people want to trade to us? I kind of want to contend for a playoff seed this year. Denzel Perryman. Pick him up. And then an outside. Let's pick up Michael Davis to trade. We'd love some trade chips. Yetir Gross. Matos. No, we want coverage. I kind of want a coverage guy to put on the outside as well. Because we love running those guys in coverage. So let's put Joe Sherbert on the team too. Nope, he doesn't have enough money. Okay. Let's see. Can we trade one of the first round picks? I don't know. I don't know if I want to though. For a really good outside linebacker though, or like a really good coverage linebacker. Like Roquan Smith. That would be insane. First round pick for Roquan Smith, I'm okay with. Okay, we give you cap, some cap shit here. Jaron Curse and Adrian Phillips. To make the cap do anything. Okay, 8th overall pick maybe. I really want Roquan. It'd be so sick. It won't work. Just want athleticism there. Edmonds would be cool. Levante David is awesome, but I mean, he's just not fast enough. Isaiah Simmons is sick. Need someone who's speedy, bro. That's all. I just need a speedy guy. Who has speed? 87 is not enough. Unless, how fast is Tremaine Edmonds? That's the real question. 87. Okay, I'm trading for Roquan. I don't give a fuck. I'm trading him. Trading for him. I don't care. I don't care what we have to give up. Do you want Trent Brown too? Leo Collins? But Leo Collins. Leo Collins in the deal too. No. He has no value. Mike Unwenu. And a second round pick. Oh, fuck. You're not even doing it, too? Okay, that's crazy. I'm not gonna. He's worth a lot, though. Oh, and he's only 27, but he has 87 speed. I thought he had like 93. Okay. Fuck it. I'm just gonna trade for Isaiah Simmons. We need a fast linebacker. Unless Barrett Carter is nice. Is he nice? 90 speed. Was that their first round pick, though? If it's their first round pick, I'm not going to do it. He was their second. Okay. I'll trade you a second this year for your second round pick. How's that? Is that fair? Jesus Christ. You guys suck. Nope, not a left end. Right outside linebacker, Marte Mapu. You want Marte Mapu for him? And you get a second this year. Did something like this with Puka Nacua. Jesus, bro, you're really taking a lot. Okay, third this year, fine. Don't make me throw up. Oh my god. You're gonna make me throw up. You're gonna make me throw up. Okay, fifth round pick, and that's my final offer. Okay, fine. And a seventh. That's fair. Fine. Barrett Carter. He's the linebacker. 90 speed. He's also has hidden dev, and he's a 78 overall, so I'm not that mad at picking up Barrett Carter. Defense. Barrett Carter. Denzel Perryman will play outside linebacker. Yep, outside linebacker there. Jacoby Brissett's going to be wearing 12, right? Yeah, no, you're not wearing 12. That's funny. There, you can wear 17. You're the backup quarterback, Jacoby. Caleb Williams is a franchise quarterback, so he's starting from day one. Xavier Worthy, you're also starting from day one. Okay, auto reorder. We're just going to auto reorder everything right now. Slot corner. Yeah, that's fine. Slot corner is going to be Kyle Fuller. Sub linebacker, Jeremiah Owusu-Aramoah. I kind of want Barrett Carter to start there, but it's just because his block shedding is crazy. His hit power is insane. His man coverage or zone coverage is worse, but he's a fucking animal. Rush D tackle, Christian Barmore, and then Devontae Wyatt. Yeah, that's totally fine. Christian Barmore's a beast. Right end, Josh Uche. Rush left. I have to change his number. Power back is fair, Zeke being the power back, but Zeke also should be the fullback. Xavier Worthy is this third down back. Zeke is going to play fullback, though. That fullback position is Zeke Elliott's. Because, yeah. And Brock Bowers is the tight end. What the fuck? Plays tight end. We do use twin tight end sets, though. So, I'm not worried about Gesicki not getting targets. We need a third tight end, though. So, let's pick one up. Nope, not the depth chart. What am I doing? Free agents, tight end. Bro, tight end. Where is a tight end? Austin Hooper? You want to sign? It's not enough money. Darren Arnold? Sure, you have 84 speed. I'd love you. All right, we have officially signed our team. Darren Arnold will be the third string tight end. We are going to do training camp. And that'll pretty much be it. And we'll see you in week one. Xavier Worthy, I'm excited to put at running back. Excited to see what he is. Rushing attack. We're going to start out Xavier Worthy, of course, at running back. Franchise running back. The give, Xavier Worthy. He's got room. Touchdown. He's got speed. That's something that he has. The 65 break tackle I don't love, but he can work on that if I upgrade power back a lot. Because his receiving back never needs to be upgraded because he's that good. Yeah, there's a tackle, Jeremiah Owusu-Aramoah. It's him and they're going up against Barrett Carter and Jeremiah Owusu-Aramoah. So that's two really good running back or two really good linebackers. So I'm not worried. Zeke, bro, what are we doing? Zeke. Oh my god, Jeremiah. Oh my god, Xavier Worthy. Touchdown, Xavier Worthy. Oh my God, get juked. Xavier Worthy. Touchdown. Xavier Worthy. Zeke, give me a block. He does. Give me another one. He does. Touchdown. So, I don't understand why I'm not getting more points, considering I'm scoring on every play. Xavier Worthy is ridiculous. Oh my God, the juke. The juke. Xavier fucking Worthy makes everyone miss. Again. Fuck, continue, whatever. I don't care. Xavier Worthy went off on that play. He feels really fun to run with. It's funny that we have another Texas running back. How did he not get a... Okay, bro. You're on dick. Let's have Hayden Dev Brock Bowers. He has 90 speed. Our tight ends are ridiculous. Mike Gesicki and Brock Bowers. That's on Christian Gonzalez, too. That's on Christian Gonzalez, too. Oh, my God. That's a good catch. I will say, we did not do that much on the defense, which sucks considering it was the 32nd defense in the league. We got, like, better linebackers, but the secondary didn't really improve other than trading for J.C. Horn, which is a nice pickup. Because he's really good at interceptions. Good catch by Brock Bowers. Let's get open again. Gets open again. Good catch again. Caught. That's gold. Run a... Oh my... That was crazy. Gold medal. Just murking Christian Gonzalez the entire time. Love to see it. Love to fucking see it. And skill points we get. All right, receiver battle now for Marvin Harrison Jr., the franchise at receiver. Him and Puka Nacua are going to kill people for years. Oh my God, dude, he's so good. Look at this. Oh my God, Marvin Harrison Jr. just murked a man. You're bugging, right? Okay, that was a bad throw by Caleb Williams, but that's okay. Caleb Williams to Marvin Harrison Jr. and Brock Bowers. This is literally like just him throwing to is just three Heisman candidates. The Mackey Award winners, Heisman Awards, Fred Blitnikoff Awards. Like, this is insane. I am happy that I sticked and picked at 4 because I was able to trade down from 8 and get the players I wanted. I still wanted Xavier Worthy. And then we still got some good defensive players in the draft as well. Wide open. Try again, though, because I want a gold for Marvin Harrison. I want him to get to an 84 by the fucking preseason. That'd be insane. That was crazy. That was insane. He just cooked Christian Gonzalez. Christian Gonzalez, bro, you need to not look this bad in game. Holy shit, Marvin Harrison's good. Look at this. He literally looks like Randy Moss right now. Caught. Easily. Is Marvin Harrison Jr.'s hair this long, though? I don't remember that. Look at this. Oh, that was not as good of a route, but he still caught it because he's fucking Marvin Harrison Jr. That's caught. Oh, it's already a gold. Ridiculous. He has gotten a 400 like every time. Ooh, okay. All right, Marvin. Gets the catch. He's cooking. He cooks. 20,000 points on that. Absolutely murdering. I'm assuming he gets an upgrade. He does. Trench battle. Who did we just pick up? Brent. We got Carter. And then we also just... got Aiden Hutchinson. I want to get Aiden Hutchinson up. Because Aiden Hutchinson, he's not sticking with 92, though. I want him to wear 50. All the white ends wear 50. Aiden Hutchinson, I traded. It was actually a pretty good package for the Lions, so I'm not that mad. Plus, he is, like, solid, but I don't think, like, he's, like, their franchise player. He's one of. Okay. Damn. Aiden. Let's go. Oh, my God. Just destroying David Andrews right there. Gets by 69, whoever 69 is. I was trying to trade for O-line the entire offseason. That's what we love to see here. Boom! On Caleb Williams' head. Aiden Hutchinson. Ridiculous. Oh, my God. You suck. Give me the multiplier. Yep. You still suck, Trent Brown. Huge hit. Aiden Hutchinson gets his X-Factor up, right? Or gets up to superstar, maybe? Come on, get him to superstar. No, just a skill point. That's fine. Pass skeleton. I'm bad at the passing ones, but I'm hoping Caleb Williams can do it. He'll still get the rookie snaps, though. Puka. He catches it. Puka, out of bounds. Incomplete. Throw it at Marvin Harris. This is just me sucking. I'm trying to find like touchdowns, so. Juju catches it. Y'all gotta stop sucking. I get sacked. There was no one open. You guys gotta go open. Puka! Damn. Puka has his X Factor too, so I mean, I'd be nervous. Good throw to Juju. The fact that Juju is still a part of the offense is crazy. Puka's still gonna be running slot though, and we'll have Marvin Harrison on the outside more. Puka, touchdown, ridiculous, gets bronze. We'll try this again. Puka gets it. Puka. Puka, nope, try again. We can get this, I think. We can get this shit. We can get this. Wow, I threw that too. I don't know why I threw that at Juju. Why did I throw that at Juju? Puka, he'll catch it because he's Puka. Juju grabs it. Puka Nacua. Nacua doing his thing. Alright, it is 12:20. That means I have to go soon. Nope. 47's a beast. I think that's Barrett Carter. Juju, that's a touchdown. Love to see it. Able to get in there. Oh, I love this route. That wheel route to Juju is insane. Touchdown. Another one. Puka, get open here. Puka makes the grab. Awesome catch. That's a good throw, too. Juju, get in. Get in. Touchdown, right? Nope. I throw a pick on the fucking goal line, too. Oh, my God. I'm an idiot. Marvin Harrison can't get open, dude. This is so annoying. All right. Whatever. Come on. Juju. Oh, what a catch. Touchdown. Let's go. Come on. Marvin. Let's go, Marvin Harrison. Try again. One more time. Then I'm going. Then the video's over. Fucking unreal draft this season. Let's get Marvin involved. Marvin doing his thing. Do we put Marvin in a big slot this season? I don't know. And an interception thrown right to Christian Gonzalez. I'm starting over because that was an awful throw by me. See, I'm bad with this shit right here. Like, oh, Puka wide open. And Puka is going to play the slot. Marvin, he'll catch it. Let's go. Love to see it from our franchise receiver that we just drafted. Puka, wide open. And I throw a pick on the goal line because I'm trying to force it into players. Puka makes the grab. Let's go. Love throwing it to Puka Nacua. He'll catch it. And gains yards. Puka Nacua. Oh my god, what a throw by Caleb Williams. Deep. I just... Oh my... Marvin Harrison Jr. comes down with it. Oh my god. This is so much... Oh, that was a good play by Jeremiah Wiso Caramel. This is so much different than... Than playing with Mac Jones. Caleb Williams can actually make throws, and my receivers, besides Puka Nacua, can catch big deep balls. Puka catches it. Big play there. There's a pick to Jeremiah Wiso Caramel. That's a fucking killer. Whatever. Marvin Harrison, he'll hang on. He is so good. That's a touchdown to Juju. Touchdown to Juju. We get it. That's a good throw. Good play by JC Horn. Just on him like white rice there. Puka. Let's go. Continue. Whatever. Does Caleb Williams get an upgrade for that? He does. Okay. Love to see it. We are gonna get upgrades. Hopefully no one's hurt. I'm just gonna sim up till week one. Aiden Hutchinson is now an 85 overall power rusher too. Oh, he also needs to wear 50. Because every white end for the Patriots wears 50. Aiden Hutchinson is wearing 50. Marvin Harrison Jr. literally can do anything. The best player on this team. Or best receiver on the squad, easily. Like, he has 86 spec catch already. 86 release. Unreal. Caleb Williams, let's upgrade the strong arm continuously. Because he can fucking sling it. Throw accuracy mid goes up by 3. He has 96 throw power already. He's an 84 already. Barrett Carter. He can cover. And I want Barrett Carter to wear 51 like Jerod Mayo. So let's put that up there. I liked trading for him because he was a second round pick. But it's not crazy to trade for a second round pick. I'm just like, it wasn't crazy to trade for a fifth round pick. Even though we gave up a lot, I don't really care. Because he's that good. Here's Brock Bowers. He'll be a really good tight end for us. Chad Ryland. He's an all right kicker. Hopefully no one's injured. Training camp standout. Who's a training camp standout? Christian Barmore. I want his block shedding to go up. Be so much better. He's received plus 5. That's amazing. Means he can shed everything. Upgrade. Puka Nacua. Ridiculous. He'll always be good. Let's get his physical up there. It's nice. Can he, like, kind of truck? 49 truck, yeah, no. Right. Yeah. Last season, this is Puka's stats, though. 118 catches, so he's nice. He's not... I'm not going to not have Puka play insanely good. He's going to be our... I don't know if he'll be our number one receiver again, because that's what he was last year. He was the number one target. Like, I'm obviously going to look at Marvin Harrison Jr., but... No, we have a couple of 10 players now. Oh, you're cut. Jonah Tavai, you're cut. Move to practice squad. Cut. 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 Move to practice squad. Move to practice squad. Move to practice squad. Cut. All right. So, Buffalo Bills is week one. We will play that in the next episode. Let's just get the depth chart set, and then that'll be the end of this extra long episode. My goodness, everything. Camp standout. Oh, I have to, like, get two combined sacks or tackles or something. Choose draft class. Let's just import 2025. I don't know if we'll do 2026, but... Yeah. Shadir's there. Okay, yeah. So, this is the right one. Cade Klubnik, Bear Alexander, Drew Aller, and all that. Let's go. Depth chart, let's do depth chart real quick. Depth chart, just quickly. Slot receiver is Puka Nacua. Yep, okay, perfect. He is that man at the slot receiver. Marvin Harrison Jr., I kind of want to play two, though. Actually, no. I want Puka to be the two, and then Marvin Harrison Jr. be the one. Yeah, that's fair. Juju, no, bro, you're not like that. That's Puka's job. But Marvin Harrison Jr. will be the one number one receiver. Puka, two. Brock Bowers, the tight end. Yeah, what are you doing there? QB. Malik Cunningham, third string. Brissett, backup. All right, guys. With that being said, that's the end of the video. I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.